come of this world or interfere in any kind of unfavorable circumstances is because both have to respect the rule of this playing field. Just like both opposite party in a football field have to respect the same rules. So similarly, in this world, there are two groups of playing. One is positive, our side, and the other one is negative, enemy side, so-called, huh? Always make trouble for us and make us obstacles and everything. We live in this world. We have interconnection with them in many lifetimes. So we cannot now, because it's our friend, we forget what we have done to them, or what our friend have done to them in the past, and just cover our friends up and treat the opposite injustly. Therefore, it's not that we don't have power. It's not that the master cannot do anything. The master can change the whole universe. But we have to be fair. Otherwise, we're not worth to be saints or saintly practitioners. That's why you see sometimes many masters, they're very patient, like Shakyamuni Buddha. He can go to any Buddha land, can do anything he wants. He can take care of disciples' karma, he can make people become arahant overnight. But he cannot change the karma of his birthplace when they have war and conflict with the neighboring country. Just because he don't want to treat people, other beings, unfairly. But that also cost him his reputation. Many people, including his disciples at that time, was losing faith in him, thinking that he cannot do anything. Even his own clan's members are being harmed, are going to be chopped away, and he can't do nothing about it. He went there and talked to them only, but that's the only thing he did. He tried to convince them the harmful effect of war and of retribution circle of karma, but they did not listen. Their karma power is too strong that they pull them together and they clash together and they die together. The Buddha could not intervene because he's a fair player. Similar to Jesus Christ, he has many magical powers, so he must be able to save himself, but he did not. He let it be. Amila Rema of Tibet, he knew that he is going to die from this poison. So in fact, he said to the woman, you first go and take the price of poisoning me from the person first, and then I drink it. Otherwise, if I drink it, I die, and he might not give you the money. So they all know before they die. Shakyamuni Buddha also know that he is going to die. He already said 3 months after, I will go to great Nirvana, leave the world. Ananda was probably thinking too much of something else, or he was hungry thinking of chapati. And he couldn't hear what the Buddha said at that time. So the Buddha said 3 times, hinting 3 times. Ananda did not ask the Buddha to remain in this world. And then Ananda woke up from his chapati dream, and he was crying, oh, please don't go. But it's too late. When the Buddha asked 3 times, and you don't answer, that's fixed. Maya, the king of illusion, always stay around Buddha. And when Ananda did not answer, the king of illusion said, see, nobody wants you. So you have to go. So the Buddha said, all right. So he knows it, but he still go. He could have waited for another time when Ananda is fully eaten and well meditated and clear mind, and then he would ask this question, and Ananda probably know what to say. Say, oh please, Master, you don't go. But he chose the wrong time, perhaps because he should have gone anyhow. Just like Milarepa, just like Jesus Christ, he knows before he went. He said, this is the last time, yeah, you see me. After tomorrow or in a while, you will not see me anymore. And he even tell his disciple, the one who dip the bread in the sauce, such and such, are the one who will sell me. So these so-called masters of the world, they know everything. They know what they're doing, but sometimes they play along with whatever it is, because this world has already come into being. You cannot annihilate it, because many people want to stay. The whole population of this world cling to this planet and don't want to let go. So even the Buddha will not destroy it. Even God will not destroy it if the karma is not so heavy. If it's still balanced, then the planet still exists. But if the planet exists, there is give and take of the karma, and it will never finish. Today they kill him, and the other day his children will kill them, and then their children will kill his children, and so on, so on, so on. Until this group of people wake up by themselves and realizing the uselessness of this forever unending evil circle. So they stop revenge and they stay still, and then everything will become different. For example, any president, if he wants to join a football team, even if he's the president and he's respected the whole world, can he join in without going any room of the football team? Can he kick around anything he wants? No. They will refuse him. Similarly, this world is a play field of the sentient beings of this planet and of this kind of level of consciousness. As in, this world is the play field of the planet dwellers, like human beings, animals, yeah, or ghosts, the goblins, those who stay around the planet invisible. So even if God wanted to come here and persuade some of his children to come home, or trying to find those who want to come home with him, he has to respect the rule of it.
Thank you for joining us on today's episode of Between Master and Disciples. Up next on Supreme Master Television is Healthy Living, right after Noteworthy News. May your days be beautiful and joyous.